Welcome back to another 7 days to die, ladies and gentlemen. That's right, it is almost 2200, day 14. We're about to get our second horde over here. We've been kind of just sitting around waiting on these guys. We put these wood spikes out down here, as you can see. Not the cones, but the other white ones. We don't really care what happens to the base. We just want to live through the night. If it's too bad, and God forbid, we have to just hop underneath and hide for the evening, then we will. Our primary goal was to hop on our mini bike and move to a new location once this horde is over with. So on the next video, our adventure will begin of us finding a new location and us building a new base. And we're going to build a base pretty much exactly like this. With the exception, we're going to start putting some outer defenses around here. Here they come. Here they come. Let's see. What side are they going to come from? We got some coming from there. Okay, we got them coming from this side right here. Wow, they're just running right over these rocks. Yeah, y'all knock that rock down. Yeah, come on, guys. Yeah, there you go. Yeah, there you go. Like I said, I didn't think this was going to be too much of a horde. Yeah, there you go, guys. Y'all just keep coming this way. And granted, we're probably not going to get a lot of kills, but that's okay. We're not after kills. If we get some, that's great. If not, that's great as well. Oh, wow, a cop. Not expecting that already. We're starting to see some police officers. Day 14 horde. Ah, that tells me our day 21 horde is going to be rather interesting. Thank you. think that's pretty much gonna. Don't think we're gonna get too much more this evening. We did get a couple of radiated cops, so. They do have a lot of times the really good loot. We got a few kills, I think, but like I said, we weren't worried too much about it. Nice getting some the police officer kills, but they did a number on that rock. There are a couple. We'll get onesies and twosies the rest of the evening. I don't expect too much more. It doesn't get bad till you get on up higher in the days, then you'll really start getting some larger amounts of zombies throughout the night. Now we do have our zombie count is high as we can get it without changing the configuration files. Of course, with this only having one person on the server, it's never going to be bad, but when you get three or four people on the server in one location, you do see a lot of zombies. So yeah, there we go. That was the pretty much the 14-day horde. We'll hang out here for a little while, and as always, once it gets a little closer, we'll probably hop down and go ahead and try to start looting. And most of the stuff we're not going to keep anyway. We don't have a lot of room. As you know, we started getting ready to... Oh, there he is. Jeez. Started getting ready for our move, so we're pretty full. We want to take the necessary items such as our building material so that we can go ahead and start on our new base. Now you watch, when he turns to a corpse, he's probably going to disappear. And so whatever loot he had on him, we'll miss out on. But that's fine. It's just a business move. We made it to 95. That's good. We're going to save these skill points. We used most of them, upgrading to some... You know, traps and things like that. And we're just gonna let her die. So as it's saying on our base move, we made a bunch of forges, workbenches and stuff so that as soon as we can get there, we can go ahead and just immediately set up. We do have our mini bike that's out there somewhere on a platform loaded up with seeds and things like that. And then downstairs is the stuff that we really want to hold on to. We'll carry that on us just in case we do lose the mini bike or anything like that crazy happens. We at least can somewhat get started. All right, she's about to drive me crazy. Really? Shut her up. least we're raising our rifle skill up a little bit. It just means more damage. Yep. Now it's just sitting around being bored. They really did a number on that rock, though. That was pretty funny. I don't understand why they all wanted to circle around the rock. I don't know if it's because the light was shining on it or what it was. We could have sat there and just picked them off. But, you know, I decided to draw them over, let them die on these spikes. So what I'm thinking about is on the Nets base, we're definitely going to get into some traps. I haven't decided how I want to do the traps. I'm thinking that I want to do blade traps right here and run power from there down to them. I hear somebody out there. It's a crawler somewhere. But I want to run blade traps down there probably on all four sides. And it just, I've never done blade traps. I've done shotgun turrets. There he is. And I think that might be pretty cool to have some blade traps right there in case they get to the inner side. It'll make quick work of them. Good old Edgar. Let's pull him away. We'd like to keep his... I think the spike got the kill, but that's okay. I wanted to pull him away so that when he turns to a corpse, he doesn't explode and disappear. He might have ammo and stuff like that on him. Did get that one. So we've got a couple hours left. We'll probably head down about 2 o'clock at game time and just defend the best we can for 2 hours and drink a beer so we don't get stunned. Do some looting. Razor scavenging. Throw a lot of the stuff in the boxes once 4 a.m. hits, or once we get done, and grab the stuff we need to take. And then when we come back to you in the next video series, we're going to hop on the old mini bike and ride off into the sunset to a new location. Get our base built. We should be able to get everything up day one. That's all we're going to concentrate on. So if you missed us building this base, you will actually get to see us build the next base. We already have a lot of materials ready to go. First thing we'll do is we'll dig our underneath portion. Just so we have an idea. I'll probably lay out the framework to get an idea of where it's going to be sitting. I hear another crawler out there. And we'll start setting up all of our storage and things like that and getting our forges up, our workbench, oven, everything that we pretty much need. And then we might not have enough time maybe day one to get everything done, but at least Yeah, he's not going to stick his head up. I'll probably just end up shooting dead corpses. I'm not going to waste my ammo on that. Oh, well. Just have to listen to him for a little while. Let's see. Tries to come over here and... But day one, we're going to try to get the base going. I know we'll get the underneath going. You know, rebarred in, all that. And then no later than day two, this will be up and running. So that'll put us at day 16 of having a base. Looking for some resources and also begin looting. And then the 21-day horde. Should be a little bit more than this. I don't expect it too much. We did get a few radiated police officers, which is quite surprising. I'll take that kill too. They do, while you hate seeing the radiated ones, at the same time you do like seeing them, because you know you're going to get some loot off of them. And the higher our scavenging goes, the better the loot we're going to get. Here comes old determined guy. Now, we weren't quite able to use all the clay and stuff like that in our forges because ran out of iron. But we're going to end up having about 200-something iron bars, which is pretty decent. Probably still going to need some more. We'll grab them out of the forest before we leave. Unless we can shut him up. Wow, guy. And we'll probably lose his loot, but that's okay. Looks like when we kill one, another one comes in. So usually, whatever base you have, the initial push is always going to be the hardest. Man, I hate those guys. They're creepy. I hear him somewhere. I don't see him. There he is. Get those spiders out. Killed. Now we're not going to have a lot of 7.62 ammo left over. We did put a few points into making shotgun shells and the regular 7.62, and we used a lot of our coal to make a lot of gunpowder to get ready for this move. We kept what nitrate we could keep on us, but this is so hard to find. And I kind of hate it because I do have a nitrate vein down below here that I found, but I'm sure we'll find another one. We'll make do. We're also going to be pretty close to our burnt biome. I believe we can find some nitrate there. And luckily this time, we're not participating in making ammo for, you know, four or five people. It's going to be a lot easier to keep up with our own ammo, our own food and stuff. When you're trying to help others out, of course, they do contribute a lot to the resource gathering, so it does help. But still, at first, when you're making everything, and it kind of comes a full-time job of constantly checking, what do you need, what do you need? Because you know, they're trying to learn the game and they are contributing resources, but at the same time, you want to make sure that these guys, they're good to go in when they're in the fight. All right, you know what? I think it's pretty boring. Give us something to do. So let's drink a beer. I do hear a few down there. And we'll just see what happens. Let's do some looting. I don't think we're gonna get much of nothing. So, I mean, that's fine. We don't expect much of nothing. Don't really need that. I hear a crawler coming around. Leave him alive. He just decided he wanted to come right up on us. Let's run over here on this side. We now have a sprained leg. Let's see if we can't make a medical bandage real quick. I mean, a splint. Probably need some duct tape. Alright. Maybe she'll give us some duct tape. No, maybe not. Anybody else? Need a little duct tape, please. Was not expecting him to crawl right up on us. Nah, it's just a crawler. Some duct tape. Alright, so we'll upgrade our black trench coat. Alright, buddy. We're gonna kind of leave you alive and we're gonna head over here and let you crawl your way over here. Where we can try to get a lot of this looting done before let's see where he's at. Okay. Yeah, I know, buddy. I know. It's gonna be all right. So we're gonna slide back over here on this side now. Don't care about the ammo, we'll leave it alone. Alright, what I'm gonna do is run around over here. See if we can't make a bandage real quick. Let's see. Let's scrap that. We'll throw that away. Science. Medical splint. We'll craft one. Then we'll use that sucker. We don't need that. All right, scrap. Let's wear this. It's better than the one we got on. We'll scrap that. I wonder where that cop was I killed out here. Like to see if nothing. Go figure. He's still mad at the world, following us around. Scrap, don't need that. Scrap, yeah, tell me about it, bud. Now, some of the stuff I might not be able to loot. Still alive. That's good. We shouldn't get any more zombies until he dies. Let's see. We can get rid of that. I'll go ahead and scrap that. You know what? Let's get another zombie. Let's drink another beer. Can't even let me enjoy my beer in peace for 1 second before you send somebody. Hopefully we'll have enough steel to upgrade quite a few of the blocks we need to be steel. Like I said, what we are going to do in the next base, we're going to start like putting a concrete ramp here. And then a lower block here, and then a ramp up, and then a block, and then a ramp down, and basically make like trenches all the way around the base out of concrete. And we're gonna lay some barbed wire on the inside of it. Now, I've done it a couple different ways in different bases, but I saw this in one YouTuber, and I like how he set that up, so that's pretty much what we're gonna do. I like the idea. It slows them down, and then it also allows you to kind of jump and have a certain area to walk on, which I do like jumping down toward the end of the horde. It conserves ammo, using our club and stuff to beat them in the head. A little more action. It's not that difficult once you get some gear and stuff and all that, and you can pretty much kite them around and beat them in the head. It just kind of gives you something to do, better than just sitting up there. And plus, if they're coming from one side and you got the turrets going, you're going to run out of ammo with those turrets. And that's, you can kind of kite them around to another area if you do run out of ammo. Let some of the other turrets take over. Scrap that. Most of the stuff we're just gonna stick in the box downstairs anyway. Good old quest item. Let's see what this is. Alright, kill some infected zombies. We'll hold on to that. Go ahead and accept it. Always take some more bandages. I think I hear another crawler out there. He can crawl his way up here while we continue looting these zombies. Mining helmet. We'll definitely take that and upgrade the one we got. Keep our eyes out for this guy that is crawling up. definitely get our scavenging up a little bit. Maybe up enough to where we can put another point to Quality Joe. That would be phenomenal. So that we can reach that guy there. Said we didn't end up with anything we weren't expecting to. Get rid of that. We'll hold on to that. We don't need it, but we're gonna stick all this downstairs. Let's see what we got over here. Anything? Yeah, we got one there. I'll tell you what, let's go ahead and get this guy here. I'll tell you what, that looks like that's gonna be about it. I know there's a crawler out there, but it's already 3:30. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna head down. Drop the stuff off. We'll keep what we want on us. Throw the rest of it in a chest somewhere. Let's see. Parts, that looks like a good place to put stuff. We're just gonna throw this stuff in there. We'll hold on to that. We already got some of that. Hold on to that. Hold on to that. Throw that in there. Let's see, ammo. How are we doing on ammo? So we got 440 iron arrows. I think what we're going to do, we're going to take our steel arrows. We don't need that anymore. We don't need that anymore. We're going to throw these coats in so we can upgrade them a little bit. And they also will do a mining helmet too. All right. That's close to 300. Nice. Let's go ahead and make these into some survivor notes. We'll read those. Outstanding. Let's go over here, and we don't have any bowls of fruit. Do we have enough to make a fruit? Nope. So I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to eat this. That topped us off there. I don't see any water. So what we'll do is we'll drink some energy drinks, even though we don't need to move around fast. All right, throw that in there. They got us topped off. Now we were able to make 100 more, it looks like, total. So that's going to put us at 241. That'll be enough to actually do the top platform. Let's take all that. Now that leaves us one space here, and then we got a couple spaces on our mini bike, but this is the stuff we want to keep on us. I'm not so much worried about these two things, but they will come in handy. We do have some gas barrels and things like that. Probably. What I probably should do is I'm going to take these and these. And I'm going to STOR. Let's see, I think I can make three of them right off the bat. Let's put this back, building material. We don't need this or this anymore. Let's take that. We'll put that down there. And there's our queue. So now we'll take three storage boxes with us so that we can put something up. And when we come back to the next video, we will move. I hope you enjoyed it. Y'all take care. Don't forget to comment, like, subscribe. Bye-bye now.